sometimes optimizing your topologies manually can take a lot of time. In most of the cases, if you just need that model for a particular use case, the time given to that process might not be worth it. So in this video, I'm going to show you a method by using which you can literally automate this process and optimize your topologies faster. And trust me on this, this will save you a lot of time. Just to break it down, as the AI revolution is advancing rapidly, we are going to use a completely AI-generated 3D model that we have created previously on this channel. If you have missed it, go check it out from here after watching this video. And the method I'm going to show you is pretty much applicable for any model that you have. But particularly for AI-generated model, we need to follow some extra step that I have figured out. So I will be showing you that. So yeah, let's see how to do it. So the program we are using is completely free. You can find the link in the description. So from here, if you go down, you will see that it has option for Windows, Mac and Linux. So we have already downloaded it. And the fun part is you don't need to install anything. You can just simply download, unzip and run the program. So yes, here we have unzipped it and let's double click to run it. Here you can see that it has this interface. And if you go to Open Mesh, you can see that it only supports like a few of the file formats like OBJ, PLY, and ALN. But the model we got from Hunyuan 3D is in GLB format. So we need to convert it and need to follow some step to optimize it better for this program. So here you can see that we have imported our model, and if you want, you can just export it into OBJ, but if you want to get a better result, you need to follow these steps. So let's go to edit mode. And here you can see that it's all triangulated and it's also have overlapping vertices. So let's just select all and then press Alt-J. What it will do is it's gonna convert the triangles into quads. But to get even a better result, we need to set the value to 90. So yes, it's gonna give a much even distribution. And after that, what we need to do is we need to press M and then merge by distance. So here you can see that overlapping vertices are gone. So yeah, now we have a much more optimized model for that program. Let's just go to File and Export into OBJ. Let's rename it High Poly Gun. Okay. So yeah, we have exported our OBJ file and let's import it into Instant Meshes. So here you can see that we have our model. And what you need to do is we need to align to boundaries and then let's just press solve. So it will give you a draft lines that how the quad flow is going to be. So I think it's looking pretty much good for me and you just need to solve it. So here you can see that it's giving you the guiding line of the quad flow. And if you want, you can also customize it. In our case, I think there is a mismatchment here. So to fix it, let's join this part and this part together. So yes, this should work. And I think we can also do it here also. So yeah, it's just giving a rough idea about the quad flow. So now we need to do is just press export mesh and extract mesh. So here you can see that we have a low polygon, and you can also customize the target vertex count to make it even much denser or less denser. So yes, now just save the model and let's rename it into lowpolygon.obj. Okay, so yeah, we have exported our low poly model. Let's import it into Blender. So here you can see that in the default model that we got from the AI, we have 19,000 vertices. So in the low polygon, we have roughly 1200 vertices. And also here you can see that we have some loose part. We can clean it up. We don't need it. And let's just delete it. Okay. But one unfortunate thing that we have from here is we don't have the texture with it. So we need to do some texture baking and apply the texture from the high poly model to the low poly one. So let's see how to do it. Let's bring the UV editor here. And we are going to make it the shader editor. So in the high poly one, you can see that we have an image texture, but in the low poly one, we have nothing. So let's add a texture and let's import an image texture. Okay, so let's create a new image. I'm going to name it Gun Texture and let's make it 4K. Okay. So after creating the image texture, what we need to do is we are going to unwrap it. Let's do a smart UV unwrap. And I'm going to increase the margin island a little bit and do unwrap. Okay. So here we have a UV unwrap. And now comes the interesting part, the texture baking. So what we need to do is we need to select this base image from the high poly mesh and then select the low poly mesh. And make sure that low poly mesh is the active mesh you have. So from here, what we need to do is let's go to cycles. And here you can see that there is an option for baking. And let's step down these samples to 150. So for the texture baking, if you use the diffuse one, like what logically makes sense, it should have worked. But I have tried with various options. It doesn't work like that. From the Hunyuan 3D model, what we get is a kind of glossy texture. So we need to press glossy and we don't need direct indirect lighting. So we just need the color. So after choosing glossy, what we're going to do is we're going to enable the selected to active option. And from here, let's increase the extrusion by 0.1 and let's keep the max ray distance 0. So after this, you need to make sure that your active object is the low poly one and your selected object is the high poly one. For that, you just need to select the low poly one first, then shift select the high poly one. So yeah, we just need to press bake now and wait for the results. So here you can see that we got an almost perfect bake. So let's just put it aside. So here you can see that we have a really detailed one. And in the remeshing process, you can increase the vertex count like to obtain more details. For like in our case, we have lost this part and the part from here. But yeah, you can see that the original one has 19,000 vertices and the remesh one just have 1200 vertices. And now if we enable the wireframe, you can see that we have a much better topology and also we have the details that we needed. So this is the default one and this is the one that we have optimized and it has a much better topology. And this process should work regardless it's being an AI generated or a sculpted model. And if you don't get an expected result, you can play with the bake type option because for this particular model, the diffuse option was not working. And from Hunyuan, we got the glossy material, so that worked for me. And it might vary depending on the model you have. So yeah, that's all for now. If you have stayed till the end of this video, consider giving a like because it really helps in the YouTube algorithm. And this is the video that I was talking about. Here you'll learn how you can make a completely AI-generated 3D model. If you want to see more this kind of video related to AI, Blender, 2D or 3D animation, consider subscribing because in 2025, I am planning to post a lot of videos. And yes, comment below that what kind of video you'd like to see next. And if you want to have a more personal interaction, you can also join our Discord server. And yeah, hoping to talk with you guys there and I will see you on the next one. Till then, ta-da!